Well, I think there's two different things that can happen. There are situations where it crosses over into a legal issue. I'm not a lawyer, nor am I a law enforcement person, but I think we all know that threats and certain kinds of behavior cross into a legal issue. And then I think you do consult with law enforcement, you do consult with a lawyer, and you do report these people to law enforcement, not, you know, not necessarily to the world, but to try and address it. But if you're talking about the kind of harassment and bullying and, you know, hate speech that happens that doesn't cross over into something that would be illegal in real life, because I do believe if it's something that would be actionable by law enforcement, if it happened in the physical world, I think it should be actionable by law enforcement if it happens in the virtual world. It may be harder for them to figure out and certainly harder for them to understand, but nonetheless. But if you're talking about just like last couple weekends ago, and I don't even post about politics on Twitter anymore because Twitter has lost itself, right? So, but I posted something I thought was an innocuous statement about data. And immediately I got all these people who assumed that my statement about data meant I wasn't supporting their candidate, and they're very vociferous about their candidate. And they started just bombarding me with like, well, what about this? And what about that? And what about this? And I'm like, whoa, dudes, this is super negative and not why I participate in social media. So I just ignored them and blocked them. And was like, I think people forget how much control they have over their own experience. Like when you're on Facebook or Twitter, you control who you follow. So you control what you see in your feed, and you control who you respond to, and you control who you block. And you control, you know, sometimes like on Facebook, I'm more likely to debate with folks. But if they're not, if they're coming to my post because they're a friend of a friend and I don't even know them, and they feel very comfortable that the first thing they should do on my Facebook wall is tell me what an idiot I am, like I'm going to be like, oh, friend of a friend that I don't know, get out of my house, right? And I think people forget that they can do that. And maybe it's turning a blind eye. And maybe you're just being monkeys, you know, what is it? See no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. But it's amazingly effective at making my online experience positive 90% of the time. I have intelligent conversation with people, not all of whom I agree with. But by deciding that I don't have to allow people who are that harsh and hateful to be in my spaces, I can have civil debate without losing my mind. And it's a worthy, I would rather like trade that off, positive civil debate versus being open to everybody's expression. It's other people can do that, but that doesn't have to be my approach to it. And I think that people do lose sight of how much they control the inputs into their online world.